So this slide shows like different modules when you keep it in a pack. Again, the pack concepts and pack is like your overall enclosure. This will go and attach to your vehicle. And what does it contain apart from the modules? It needs that entire cooling system, cooling lines, and then the BMS, the sensing circuits will be inside the battery pack. The one more major thing is the battery disconnect unit. It has to be electrically disconnected when the cover is open, because you don't want to get electrocuted by when you are touching the terminals. And what is the heat stakes? So I already mentioned, if there is a thermal runaway, if any one of the cell catches fire, you don't want that fire to be propagated to different modules. So you will have a heat stake, heat inhibitors that will not pass the heat through conduction. So the other module will not see the next module is getting electroclated or getting short circuited, or high temperatures are rising. So heat stakes are main. And you need a very good strong battery pack structures, because I have the regulation requirements. You could see the crash and vibration, shock, all of those requirements has to be taken care by this pack structure. So pack will be mainly made of sheet metals only, but you will have a lot of reinforcements being inside. The one more critical requirement of the pack is that it has to seal the entire lithium-ion battery pack from your external environmental things, because you don't want the water vapor or moisture to enter inside the modular lithium-ion cells, because as I mentioned earlier, water reacts with lithium very violently. So you can see YouTube videos. So it's like an explosive. So the sealing system is another critical requirement for the battery pack. So I try to highlight what are all the regulations that are in place. The blue rectangular box is highlighting, in terms of mechanical, what are all the things that C means a cell, M means module, P means pack, V means vehicle level. So the countries have put forth the stringent requirement, mainly USA and then China and then European countries. International is separate. India also has regulation requirements for cell and module. So predominantly it's like a mechanical shock and drop of the battery pack and penetration. Penetration is like a critical safety requirement. Like if your electric vehicle are getting crashed into some other part and some protruding part penetrated inside your battery pack, you don't want that battery pack to explode or electrocute. So that is a special requirement for the module and pack in the international requirement. And immersion is like the water. I have separate slides to explain you, but I'm giving you overall. So if it submerges into a water source or sea, so this water can seep in through the pack and cause the fire. So the battery pack has to be strong enough that it doesn't seep the water inside. And there are separate vehicle crush and crash rollover requirements apart from the vibrational part. So we'll go over them in detail quickly. What is a mechanical shock? Mechanical shock is like you are giving a sinusoidal pulse like in all three directions. The sinusoidal pulse, half sine pulse, will be like it depends on the battery pack or module. Generally 25G is what given as a normal above 12 kg pack. So this 25G pulse will be given in a fixture and on the module as well as on the pack level. So what does this physically mean? Like if your vehicle is undergoing a pothole condition, you are hammering, the vehicle will go a jolt, a severe jolt. So in that case of severe jolt, what will happen is, because of the 25G is not a very small amount, the acceleration will be passed inside the module, and all of them are the terminals, and the cells also will move and bang against whatever the part it is stopping them. And you don't want the electrical and the cooling lines or anything to get short circuited and cause in any. So the pass criteria is no fire, no explosion, no rupture, no leakage. So the battery pack should remain same. So no electrocution, no fire incident should happen. And the shock duration is mentioned. You can go through. And what is the state of charge requirements also? And mainly, you can consider the requirements from USA and European countries. So European countries have a vehicle level collision requirement for shock, apart from the standard 25G or whatever, based on the vehicle or the battery pack mass requirements. It is R95 and R94. It is like a frontal and side impact, and the rear impact requirements wherein the battery pack, when it is subjected to those tests, this vehicle impact, vehicle crash, it will also produce sufficient shock to the battery pack or the internals. So the battery pack has to sustain the shock and it should not catch fire, or of course the pass criteria is given below. So mechanical shock is the major requirement for the battery pack. The drop test is like you drop the battery pack when you are servicing. It's possible that whichever carrying the battery pack, we may miss it. It may, the worst condition is 2 meter, like a human height, it gets dropped. So how does it matters? Because depending on the flat surface and wherever the which part of the battery pack is touching, so there could be a different possibility of different points are getting excited, or the G levels can go into the pack, or it's mainly on the pack. So that's why you can see only pack. And USA has requirements for module and cell also. So this is mainly on the to test the service requirements or during the build requirements. Yeah, penetration test. As I mentioned, lithium-ion but cells are like explosive in your car. So the countries give a penetration. They take a rod of 3 mm and they push that rod. So it is there for cell as well as for the modules. So they penetrate this from outside. Maybe you need to have sufficient margin or clearance space available outside the module, so that the 100 mm when you push inside, it generally they will ensure that it will not touch the cell. But even if it is touching, they ensure that the damage, what's happening inside, is there will be damage to the cells, but they ensure that the cells do not catch thermal runaway or the fire incidents, which can cause to make the test fail. So, but the functionality, it need not be that the battery will function, but you don't want any untoward accidents or any loss of life or any loss of property to happen because of this test. That's a pass requirement. Immersion test. So this immersion test is like you submerge entire battery pack for 2 hours. It's a sodium chloride is nothing but your salt water with a temperature of 25 degrees Celsius. Once you immerse it, again, there is a pressure height requirement also. It will be above atmospheric, and you keep the battery pack in your full charge state, 95 to 100% charge state. So mainly this immersion test challenges your the sealing requirements of your battery pack. So it does exist mainly for the pack and module level. So even when you take the module, if there is a separate enclosures are available, then you don't want the electrical conduits or cooling conduits, when they are coming out, they should not pass the water inside the pack and then cause any untoward accidents. Rollover test. This rollover test is like, okay, it is like it is a follow-up after your shock or immersion, all the test. This is the final test. So here the entire modular pack will be rotated 90 degree, and then for 5 minutes, and then we see any like any loose components which might have during the shock or the other events. During rollover, there is a possibility that any loose components, they will come in contact with the electrical things, and again it will cause any untoward incidents like fire or explosion. So they check this rollover test as a final one. crush requirements, again, I will leave to the audience. For the sake of time, it is similar to penetration. So some static load is applied, and then you see are the cells and modules do take that crush load. It is mainly to simulate the vehicle crash events and how much load is going to the pack and modules. The vibration performance is mainly for the durability case. Like whatever we have seen is for the safety requirements. Vibration is like for the life. You need the entire road load will give excitations to the battery pack. So this is like you give between 10 to 100, 200 hertz. You give amplitudes to a shaker table, and then you give in the cell and module level and the pack level, and you vibrate all three axes and see the battery pack doesn't have any failure which is seen inside. So this is mainly for the durability case. Okay, so whatever we have seen is the regulations which definitely the battery pack or the module has to meet. So I will touch some quick points which you can keep in your mind. Thermal runaway is the very major requirement for the battery pack. The point of egress is how the like vent gases has to come out. There should be a clear path, and there need to be a thermal barrier between the modules. And how do you cool it? And that is also part of your thermal management system for the battery pack. And for the electrical thing, you need electrical disconnect. Whenever there is a crash, the circuit should sense and should isolate the battery from the externals, and also the crash requirements in terms of crash and the mechanical shock which goes inside the battery pack. And if you consider of the mechanical aspects, then the battery pack has to sustain the crash, vibration isolation, or entire vibration for the entire life of the battery pack. And then the thermal shock, majorly the plastic and other components, because the temperatures vary over and UV rays, they will degrade the system in terms of the mechanical strength. So you need to, when you are designing the battery pack, you need to consider thermal as well as the vibration as the critical, and the crash requirements as the additional requirement for the battery pack. Apart from mechanical, you have battery management and the cooling circuits, cooling conduits, how do you route them for a better packaging and cost saving requirements. So all these are like a multidisciplinary requirements for the battery pack. Okay, this I have covered. So the Europe has R12, R94 and R95, mainly frontal side and rear impacts. And then USA also has multiple requirements for the crash, which test or which ensures that the battery pack is more safe and more reliable, and it can go into the road without any safety issues. Battery cooling, so how do we sense any battery is like any short circuiting is happening inside the battery pack? Is the temperature distribution between the cells, if it is more than 3 to 4 degrees, there should be an effective mechanism which will sense, and it will disconnect the battery. It will shut down so that you don't draw any power or you don't charge any power. And also the battery cooling is active cooling. It ensures that you don't maintain a difference of thermal difference inside the battery pack, and you don't allow any uncontrolled temperatures to rise within the battery pack. There are three types of cooling available: liquid cooling, air cooling, and immersion cooling. So liquid cooling is more common. Air cooling was used by Nissan Leaf in the first generation, but most of them is like a refrigerant cooling which Tesla uses. You can use a better cooling so that with the phase transfer you can have major heat transfer can occur. You can carry more heat from the battery pack so that you can maintain the temperatures within that. Immersion cooling is the latest trend which is coming, but it's like you immerse within the within a container you immerse the entire cell so that it's like uniformly it's cooled down. This slide talks about the critical parts like we generally come across in our day-to-day life. in case of we use the battery packs for storing energy or in the electric vehicles. So predominantly there could be a penetrations inside the lithium ion cells, or there could be an electrical short circuiting by abusive charging or abusive discharging. And when you carry the battery packs through shipping, like through road as well as through air, it's like a shock load which goes inside the battery pack. It's going to be concerned. Mainly the debris throwaway particles is like when you drive the electrical vehicle at the bottom. This is the bottommost part of your car. So any debris or any sharp or nails can directly go and pinch your battery pack. So you need to have a sufficient safety under armor so that it doesn't penetrate. And abusive usage, I have mentioned, and then there need to be water sipping, no water sipping, or the sealing requirements has to be very much proper. So this slide tells about what are all the day-to-day which we can feel that the battery pack need to have. Okay, this might be like a very critical one. So what does the thermal runaway tells? Why does it occur? That mainly it is coming from the cell internals. When you overcharge it, or whenever there is a flaw in separator is playing a major role in the runaway problems. So if there is a short circuit happens, then there is a free movement of electrons between anode to cathode. It need not take any external circuit. It can pass internally. Once it passes, the gap widens, and there is a direct path which is available for all of them to mingle together and form an explosion. And also the one more thing is that lithium dendrite, sometimes they call it as a SEI layer. So that SEI layer, if it which forms around the electrolyte, so this is a solid electrolyte interface which we call, if that because of the dendrite growth there will be cracks, and through the cracks the electrons can pass through. So once there is like there is a three reactions, it's like an onset, and then once it start propagating, all your separator and the additives which you add inside the anode and cathode, all are all hydrocarbons. So if there is a temperature rise, they will self-ignite, and once self-ignites, you allow more path for the electrons to pass through, and all the chemical reactions will catastrophically auto-ignite and catch fire. So this is a brief introduction for the thermal runaway. Okay. So it's like onset of overheating, it's because of the dendrites and separator flaws. So this is the first stage. The second stage is you accumulate the heat, you allow the separator to melt, and then the solid electrolyte interface layer also decomposes. This is like a protective layer. I can tell you what is SEI layer on. And once you expose the anode, or mainly anything exposed, it's all very reactive lithium. So heat accumulates, and then once heat rises to a particular limit, the temperature rises, all of your internals catch fire, and then goes for a thermal runaway. You can see in YouTube how a thermal runaway for any lithium ion cells. So within seconds and within minutes, they catch fire. And you don't want that even to pass through other modules or other cells. So the requirements of the battery pack is, if there is a thermal runaway, let it be, but it has to be limited within that particular cell or module which is happening, so that you avoid the damage, or you minimize the damage which is coming to the entire battery pack or entire system. Okay, having said that, how we design it, and in the industry in India, how do we go ahead? So the CAD tools are mainly CATIA Unigraphics, which helps us to design the routing, sensing circuit, the layout of the modules, battery pack, what. So in the cost, everything will come under. And you also make hand calculations and the basic crashworthiness calculations. Once you have a particular design and you validate that through structural analysis and crash analysis, the tools mainly in the industry are ANSYS, Abaqus, and LS-DYNA. And for durability, use ENCODE and FE-SAFE. And CFD solvers mainly take care of the thermal management of the battery packs. So the battery packs are going to be the futures, and the electric vehicles are predominantly are making use of the lithium ion battery packs. There are different chemistries available, but lithium ion is, as far as we have, is the major contender for the high voltage battery pack. And getting insight to this lithium ion battery pack, how we need to design the module, what are the test requirements, and others also electrical and BMS will help for an EV engineer to focus their career path in the future requirements of industry. We need to focus how the industry trend is evolving. And as far as IC engines, there will be after 2030 and 40, no more IC engines. Only the electric vehicles are the future. So it is better to shift our gears towards the electrical vehicle technology and the lithium ion battery packs. Sai Suma.